Hello everyone. Let us discuss a image-based question in ENT. A 45-year-old man presents with right side nasal block for 1 year. Anterior rhinoscopy reveals a mass filling the right nasal cavity with an irregular surface, no ulceration. It is pale pink in color. On probing, the mass is soft, not friable, does not bleed on touch, seems to be arising from lateral wall. Histopathological picture of biopsy taken from the mass is shown. What is the diagnosis? Options given are A. Schwannoma, B. Inverted papilloma, C. Squamous papilloma, D. Squamous cell carcinoma. So here an image is given which shows the histopathological picture is given. So this lesion has a thickened epithelial covering. The lesion has a thickened epithelial covering. Thickened epithelial covering. And another characteristic feature is this hyperplastic epithelium, they show extensive invasion into the underlying stroma rather than exophytic manner. So this characteristic feature of invasion of the underlying stroma rather than exophytic manner is the characteristic feature of inverted papilloma. So the histopathological picture given is a classical feature of inverted papilloma. So the correct option for this question is inverted papilloma. So let us discuss some of the important points related to inverted papilloma. So what are the things we should know about inverted papilloma? Inverted papilloma is known by different other names also. So what are the synonyms for inverted papilloma? The synonyms for inverted papilloma, what are the synonyms? It is also known as Ringett's tumor. It is also known as Ringett's tumor. It is also known as Ringett's tumor, transitional cell tumor, transitional cell tumor, or Sneiderian cell papilloma. Sneiderian cell papilloma. So these are the other names by which the tumor is known. This tumor arises from the non-olfactory mucosa of the nose, which is known as Sneiderian membrane. So what is the most common site of origin? The most common site of origin is lateral wall of nose. Most common site of origin is lateral wall of nose. So it is a rare tumor, only 0.5% of the nasal tumors. So sometimes it is associated with the human papilloma virus 6, 11, 16 and 18. It is a benign tumor, but in 10 to 15% of cases, it is associated with malignancy. So it is a benign tumor. Benign tumor, but 10 to 15% of cases, it is associated with squamous cell carcinoma. 10 to 15% of cases, it is associated with squamous cell carcinoma. Almost always it is unilateral. So always it is unilateral. It mimic nasal polyps in appearance. So investigations, we have to go for CT scan or MRI. So MRI shows a characteristic convoluted cerebriform pattern. Characteristic convoluted cerebriform pattern. So the confirmatory test is biopsy. So with the biopsy is essential for diagnosis, and the treatment of choice is medial maxillectomy. So the treatment of choice is medial maxillectomy. So medial maxillectomy can be performed by lateral rhinotomy, sublabial degloving approach, or nowadays endoscopic approach is the best option for medial maxillectomy. So with this, we will finish our discussion on inverted papilloma. Thank you.